Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I'm still here in Seattle at Highline Community College. Mike Jelen, Girvin. Now, Mike got this question on YouTube this morning. He said, someone has a whole column of prices here, and they want to reduce all of those by 35%. And so we're going to play dueling Excel again, my way and his way, and see which way we want to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little formula here that basically I want to get 65% in there. And so now 1 plus, there we go, 65%. So we're good. I'm going to copy that and change it to values. So, of course, the fast way to go is just go to the right edge, drag right, drag left. That was with the right mouse click, copy here as values only. Now I'm going to copy that. I'm going to come over and choose my range of prices. So Control Shift down arrow to choose that. And then I use Alt E S M, the multiply operation. Now, one thing I want to do here is I then want to go up and hit values because I don't want the formats coming over. I don't want the green being pasted over. I don't want the percentage being pasted over. So multiply and values, and I click. Let's just take a quick look here. We were at 66.19. I click OK. And we're down to 43.02, which seems like about a 35% reduction. Now, that's the one thing with this, you know, you have no audit trail to go back and check it. But order of magnitude, it sounds about right. So that's my method. Now, I'm going to undo to get those original numbers back. I'm going to keep undoing, and we'll have Mike show us his method.
All right, now that was a good one, not bringing that format over with the paste special values. Another way to do this is I would do the same thing, equals 1 plus that minus 35%, and then I just create a new column, new price. I'm going to click here and come up to the home ribbon and grab that little thing and click right there. And now I'm going to do a simple formula, equals one cell to my left times this 65%. Now I need to lock this, and since I'm going down across the numbers, the rows, I'm going to hit F4 twice, so the dollar sign's just in front of the number. Control Enter to keep that cell highlighted, and then double click and send the fill handle down. Hey, did that work? It did. Look at that. The audit trail right here. We started with 10. It goes to 650.
Perfect. That better. That's a good one.
So there you go.
All right, sweet. There you have it. Two different ways to solve that problem. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.